I now request Mr. Subhodeep, Ordnance Factory, Ambernath, to give his presentation.
Good afternoon to all of you. Many esteemed speakers have spoken about, from morning I am hearing, and a lot of good things about our country, what our Honorable Prime Minister is planning to do, make in India, all the good things. I am from Indian Ordnance Factories. I don't know, many people may not even know ordnance. People confuse even also with ordinance. There is a difference of only I. One single I is missing. If you remove that I become ordinance. If you add that I become ordinance. Ordinance goes to parliament. Ordinance is behind the armed forces. We are here sitting enjoying this seminar because what our armed forces are doing at their duties in the borders. If you happen to go there, be there somewhere, sometimes with army, you will feel ki how tough their lives are. I have the experience of doing that as a part of my training. And that day I felt ki how tough the life of those army men are. I'll just take 1 minute to share my experience. I was in Manipur with Assam Rifles Commando Unit. We were taken for a night sortie ki how they do this night visits and all. And I lost myself in between. And that area is full of this militant area and all. So one of my friend also lost somewhere in between. So, and it was so dark and it was so difficult. Then we, and somehow then they came and searched me out. So that day I appreciated and I applauded the efforts of those armed forces. Ki what they are doing for us, you cannot appreciate sitting here. We should give a salute to those people. Then at least I feel ki I have joined this department. I feel happy. I feel privileged that at least the ordnance people, the 1 lakh employees of the ordnance department are behind our armed forces. We are the fourth arm of the defense, although hidden one. You may not see our department because you see those army, navy and air force people. These Air Force people are sitting and I must salute them. They are doing a great job to us. So we are behind them, helping them to make our country safe, safe for us to stay, safe for us to enjoy, safe for us to do good work inside the country. With these words, I will start my presentation. Just a brief about Ordnance Factories, what we are. We are under Ministry of Defense. Defense Ministry is having three basic arms. One is main defense, which is that is Army, Navy and Air Force. Then on defense R&D, which DRDO comes into picture. We are under Department of Defense Production, in which Ordnance Factories, DGQA and Defense Public Sector Units comes. Like your Majgaon Dock Limited is a Defense Public Sector Unit. Like this, there are other seven BDL and GRC, Hindustan, Bharat Electronics and all are Defense Public Sector Units. So together with this means Ordnance Factories and Defense Public Sectors maybe take care of about 40 to 45% of total armed forces requirements. And if you look at the Navy and Air Force, our contribution is even lesser, hardly 2 to 3%. So here definitely Make in India slogan is very important for us. We should, there is a huge potential for not only for Ordnance Factories, for public sector enterprises and private sector units also to bridge this gap. The gap is huge. You can imagine the gap is few lakh crore rupees to be bridged up. So here's, I feel Prime Minister Modi's Make in India campaign is very important. Just in brief, the organization structural key, it is headed by a chairman and held by 9 members. The birth of our department was, it's more than 214 years old organization. 18th March 1801, it was started by Britishers. I feel that was also a Make in India campaign only by Britishers that time because they wanted to further extend their colonial interest and to avoid costly and unsafe transportation from their British area. So that was maybe 1801, they started a Made in India campaign. And so from that first factory in 1801, now we are about 40 strong factories and 41st factories coming up in Korwa, Uttar Pradesh. Two photographs you can see. Left side of me is the first simplified cannon, and the right side of me, this is the latest indigenized Bofors gun which we have done. This is called Dhanush, which is being handed over to army now. So if you remember this Kargil war, we have won because of this Bofors gun. Although there was a lot of issues with Rajiv Gandhi ji and all those, our ex-prime minister. But if this Bofors gun would have been not there, we would have lost Kargil war. Because this gun can fire from high altitude. Means, it has a very high angle of firing. So when Pakistanis were firing from the other side of the mountain, if this would not have been there, we would have lost the war. We would have been... Something would have wrong would have gone to us. So ordnance factories have made this gun with all Make in India efforts, with definitely help from public sector enterprises, private enterprises. We have made it dream and made this dream true, and we are going to hand it over to army now. All the trials are over. So applause for not only ordnance factories, for all public private enterprises who have contributed, all public sector enterprises who have contributed to this. If you see the, as I told you, we have about 41 factories spread all around the India, starting from Chandigarh at the north to the bottom is Arvankadu, that is near Uti, and western side in Maharashtra, we are about 10 factories, and in Maharashtra itself is we have 10 factories, and most of the factories have come to socio-economic development of backward areas where no private sector will open its plant. We have plants in Ordnance Factory Bolangir. Bolangir is in a remote area of Odisha. I don't think many private sector will like to go there. But okay, it's a government's decision to take care of the welfare of that area. So about 40, 41 factories we have there. It is spread length and breadth of the our country. We have about 214 years of rich experience in defense production, comprehensive product range. We have fully integrated manufacturing facilities. Our thrust is also on indigenization, rigorous quality standards, our capacity to produce wartime requirements. We have war reserve capacity. In case war takes place, we can come to the fore and help our armed forces to save our motherland. Our mission is production of state-of-the-art battlefield equipments. A vision and all due to shortage of time will skip. Our core competencies are in these areas: weapons. We produce small, medium and large caliber weapons and mortar equipment. In ammunition explosive and propellants, we do small, medium and large caliber ammunition, mortar bombs, signaling and related stores, rockets and bombs, fuses, explosives, chemicals and propellants. In military vehicles, from trucks to mine protected and special security vehicles, even just a small incident, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu has come under a bomb attack, mine attack when he was visiting Tirupati. He got saved because he was traveling in a specially mine protected vehicle, and that was first started by Ordnance Factory Medak. That was supplied by Ordnance Factory Medak, one of our sister factories. That day he could be saved. Now many private people have also entered, like Mahindra and all, but maybe 10 years or 15 years back only ordnance factories were doing this. Now armored vehicles, we are doing tanks, APCs and engines, instrument and optical devices, parachutes, we are producing brake parachutes, man dropping and supply dropping, troop comfort and general stores, tentage, clothing, personal equipment, bridges, boats. You can see the variety of our products from a simple shoe. The army man wears from a simple shoe to tanks, to armored protected carriers, to all rockets, rocket launchers. We have started into like Pinaka multi-barrel rocket launcher, Pinaka, and also we are producing now. Because this is a non-ferrous meet, so just a glimpse what are the non-ferrous metals which we are using. We are using electrolytic cathode copper, basically to about 8 to 10,000 tons per annum. Zinc ingot, which we are using about 3 to 4,000 per annum. Primary aluminium ingots of 99.7% purity. The requirement is about 3 to 4,000 per annum. Aluminium alloy plates, these are special alloy plates of medium strength aluminium alloys, which only Hindalco is supplying at present in India. Pure nickel and lead, nickel, as we have discussed, there is no source in India, it is all imported. oxygen free high conductivity copper for a special type of heat ammunition which is used for penetrating the tank armors. Then gilding metal strips, 7030 brass strips, different types of copper based alloys, aluminium bronze castings for Mazak alloy, which is zinc based alloy, tungsten powder. Tungsten powder is not available again indigenously. It is all coming from imported route. These are used for FSPDS ammunition, which is used for penetrating the tank armor. Then iron powder, cobalt powder, nickel powder, various sizes of medium and high strength aluminium alloy rods, tubes, profiles of 2 series, 5 series, 6 series and 7 series alloys. These are all medium and high strength aluminium alloys. Different types of aluminium based master alloys, pure magnesium and boron. Many of the things also goes for our integrated guided missile development program also, which we are part of late we have started. Our vision 2020, as our senior GM Sahib, Mr. Hariharan Sahib, has already morning has spoken about, we are planning for a quantum jump in issues, if not double, at least 70-80% in our jump. So what we require from public and private sector is in sourcing our raw materials, helping us to produce sub-assemblies and semi-finished components, processes such as surface finishing, packaging, material processing, units which are having quality standards and NABL accredited can be a part of us. Specifically to my factory where I am working, that is Ordnance Factory Ambernath, these are the areas we can get help from. Cast brass ingots, 7030 brass and 9010 gilding metal continuous cast coils, rolling and slitting of copper alloy strips, cast billets of medium and high strength aluminium alloys. These are what we require from you to double our capacity, because although whatever fast we do in government sector, it takes time to create infrastructure and it's a capital intensive process also. So there will be always some gap between what is our capacity and what is final requirement. So these are the areas we are looking help from private sector agencies if we have to achieve that vision 2020 or 2022 or vision 2018, whatever we say. And these are the areas where we are offering our help in civil sector, means we are selling this cast brass ingots, grade 4 brass and aluminium dross. So these we are selling in open market. If anybody is interested, they can contact us. For more information, you can log on our site also. That is www.oib.gov.in. I thank you for your patience here.
Thank you, Maridia sir.